Welcome to Move Leadership in Motion. We have been talking about our growth formula, what we've kind of coined as our growth formula here at Hope, and it's one of the ways that we use to start and revitalize ministry areas that we are trying to move forward or create anew. And so we've already talked about vision, we've already talked about plan, and today we're going to be talking about discipline. Now, discipline and plan go hand in hand, and they're really closely linked. I have to admit, and I think you feel the same way, it's not my favorite part of the growth formula.
Least favorite.
Yeah.
Really, this is, you're now really into the nuts and bolts of making this happen. So the planning is still kind of big picture in some ways. It's coming down a little bit more from vision, which is my favorite part.
Yes.
The discipline now is actually taking the plan and breaking it down into its various elements that include things like timelines, calendar, who's going to be responsible for each piece, and so what we call the nuts and bolts of putting together the plan.
Yeah, it's getting down and dirty. You know, it's really the, okay, how many different teams do we need, and what areas are they going to cover, and how often they're going to meet, and who's going to lead each one, and who are they going to be accountable to, which we will talk about in our next segment. But all of these things are part of the actual discipline, and this is where you've really, you've got that calendar out, and you are marking things down, and you are getting it onto the calendar so that you are sure that you're meeting these different goals that you're setting to stay on track. Because otherwise, it's really easy to get lost in the weeds, and you either get stuck talking in circles about things that ultimately aren't that big of a deal, or it just feels so big and overwhelming that you don't know where to start. It's like my kid when I tell her to go clean her room, she looks at it like I don't even know where to start.
Start with the closet.
Yeah.
Yeah, so the one of the things that we did a number of years ago was we were going through a major reorganization of how we do leadership from a more administrative council model that is familiar to those of you who are United Methodist to what we identified as a lead team model. And this was going to be a huge change in our approach to leadership. And so we said this is going to be a year-long process, and so we talked about each month what we were going to be doing and who was going to be involved in the process and what each individual player's role was going to be within that process, and we documented all of that. And so it takes time to create the disciplines after the planning is laid out. But once you have it, then that becomes kind of the blueprint, or the next level of the blueprint. And so that served us really well. And at the end of that year, we had been through this really good process with everybody knowing what their role was going to be.
Yes.
And at the end, when we had to vote on changing this thing, it was a unanimous vote because all of the hard work had been done all the way through the process.
Yes. Yes, I am. There are some legitimate times, though, when things seem to stall in that. And there are times where you just feel like, what just happened? And so a couple of the things you can do, you can step it back and you can look and see, okay, where did this breakdown occur? And sometimes we have volunteers that came in and they were super amped up and either their energy fizzled out or their life circumstances changed, new jobs or different responsibilities at home. And suddenly they don't have the same time and energy level to commit, and you find yourself stuck, like we're not moving forward. So that's something that you can take a minute to evaluate. And, you know, one of the things that I know you've talked about a lot is the difference between zeal and motivation, you know, and we see that so clearly at times when we have new projects or new ministries that are launching.
Yeah, people get excited about something new oftentimes, and so that's the zeal. They're excited about it, and it's new, and it sounds exciting, and so forth. The difference with that and a motivation is when somebody feels really passionately about something, even when it gets hard, even when you're into the weeds and you feel frustrated and people aren't showing up and all of those things that happen, when the motivation is strong, and we'll talk about this as another part of our formula, that gives you the energy and the drive to continue to move through, even when stuff gets kind of bogged down.
Yeah, it gets challenging.
The other thing is, just real quick, with the discipline, sometimes we get it wrong. You know, we think it's going to take a certain amount of time, and we realize as we're going through the process, we really didn't give this enough time, and we need to make some adjustments. And so, again, flexibility in all of this is so important. You want to have a plan, you want to have the discipline set, but things happen, and flexibility is really important.
Yeah, I feel like having this reassessment built into your discipline is crucial. So it's one of the things that I feel like we do frequently when we're starting a new ministry area or launching a new program or something like that, is to say, are we still on track? Do we still feel like this is the right direction? Do we still feel like, you know, this is where we're supposed to be headed, or do we need to reassess this plan? You know, is there something in the plan that needs to change? And that gives us the freedom to truly say, yeah, no, I was wrong, and we got to redirect over this way. You know, we got to course correct. So it's great to build that into your discipline, that opportunity to look and say, hey, where are we? And are we just needing another, you know, swift kick to get going? Or is it really that we need to reassess and re-strategize?
So we are excited about growth. Everybody wants to grow, I think, in their churches. And we have found that this process that we call the growth formula is really helpful. And we hope it's helpful to you as well. And so our next one that we'll be looking at will be looking at accountability, and I hope you'll check that out as well. And as always, if there's anything we can do to help you as you're trying to grow your ministry, please feel free to give us a call or contact us at Hope.